Martin Luther King fought for equity with passively expressing his mind and passively walking through the streets and expressing himself. No matter how you look at this video is an art form. It's an art form. It's something you're supposed to take seriously, but no matter how you look at it, the three to four murders I showed in the beginning were murders done by supremacists that were real. That white boy is still alive. So the people that died in the video are real. Everyone is so bothered by the child being lynched, but whether you realize it or not, the murders in the beginning are all real. Heather Hare, Emmett Till, Philando Castile, these are real murders. This Caucasian child is still alive. It's art portrayal. Now, as far as the message, everyone feels like it's reverse racism, and really it's not. It's just reverse portrayal. So it's me basically putting the shoe on the other foot, showing another perspective. And there's a bigger message behind it, but I want you to perceive that for yourself. I just think it's important that the message is clearly received and that everyone understands that this is not a motive towards more racism. This is a motive towards equity, just showing how it feels and how wrong it feels on the other, basically on the for the other race. So I understand if you're bothered, obviously, by the child being hung because obviously it's done for shock value. I couldn't hang a 40-year-old Caucasian man and get the same response. It's not in any shape or form a promotional method. It's just so I can emotionally bother you. It's supposed to bother you. It's supposed to make you feel wrong. It's supposed to make you feel fucked up so that way you see what's going on is wrong. Because whether you realize it or not, a biracial child just a few days ago was true. While they attempted to hang him, I don't know the story stemming behind it, but this is still going on. And it's really sad that no one feels the need to take a stand and make a difference. And the only way we're gonna do that is if we put our heads together and really see the bigger picture. Man, let there be peace meetings. Let there be moments of rejoicing about the fact that obviously we're moving forward in this life. Let there be moments that we basically appreciate our prosperity as people. If everyone becomes unified and we start movements of unity, well, obviously the hate will poke its head out. We're gonna see these people poke their heads out and try and ruin. They're gonna try and ruin the peace that we're keeping. But with that being said, I apologize to anyone I've offended within the last couple of hours. Obviously, you guys know I'm going through a lot just due to this case and just with a lot going on. But I understand. I just want to express that I understand. And with what I said yesterday, I mean, I don't retract my statement. I like to be an asshole when I want to be an asshole, but I just want to show everyone that I'm not exactly what everyone thinks I am, you know? Just picture this, trying to wake up every day with a positive mindset, and you go on the internet and thousands of people are telling you to kill yourself and that you're a worthless nigger and that you're fucking stupid and calling you all types of fuck ass shit. I've never felt the need to try and assert myself or to prove anything to anyone, but if I want to assert myself in my career or have my views respected, I realize that I have to treat everything with care and take time and have patience with people. So I'm going to be doing an interview sometime soon to not only cover my views as far as the video and just my overall views, but just to explain myself to people and to give people the opportunity to understand me. Peace, love, prosperity, and equity is what I really truthfully want to see for this world. And I don't want for us to be the reason why we end up going through an apocalyptic state in this world. I just want to see this world maintained for years. Sorry, not years, but centuries, millennials. I just want to be able to see the youth of this generation and future generations be able to experience, obviously, what the previous generations have experienced. And be able to live out their lives. It feels wrong to wake up every day and feel like the world is gonna end due to our unjust leaders and unjust people that obviously rule this country, and we won't make a difference unless we take a stand as people. And I understand we cannot evolute or elevate ourselves unless there's destruction in order for creation, but destruction in order for what? Destruction in order for the prosperity of our people, or destruction for just blatant destruction. In the end of the day, you don't have to like me because I understand the severity of the accusations that were made against me in the past. But regardless of that, you have to understand that I'm preaching a positive message no matter how you look at it, and that all I want for us as humans is to prosper. Again, genuinely, I apologize for not being as patient as I should be. And I just want people to know that I'm not trying to lead their children down a dark path, and that I really want something good for the human race. So with that being said, I hope everyone has a good day. And go look at the video.